Kay Arthur has been teaching the Bible for almost 50 years, with over 100 books in 70 different languages. Daily radio, television, and online programs, and a global ministry, she's helped countless people discover the truth of God's Word for themselves.
We have people that have no concept of sin, no understanding of sin, but you and I understand it because we understand the Word of God, and we've got to be willing to share the Word of God with them.
In her new book, Heaven, Hell, and Life After Death, she teaches about what happens after we die.
Well, Kay is with us on the show today. I think as I listen to that about how fearful Christians are in the day that we live in. Why?
I think it's because we either fear the pain of death, the act of the process of death, or we fear what's going to happen when I die, because it seems so final. Yeah. And really, death is not final. It is the stepping stone into eternal life or eternal hell.
Which is what we were created for, is the eternal life.
We were created for the eternal life, and man blew it, so God took care of it. And he took care of it through his Son. Mm-hmm. And many people don't know, but the first promise of the death of Jesus Christ is found in Genesis 3:15.
Wow.
When he turns and he looks at the serpent, and he pronounces judgment, but then he tells how the seed of the woman is going to crush the head of the serpent.
Yeah.
And there, that's, they call it the proto-evangelicum, the first promise, the first good news.
Yeah.
And so immediately when man sins, you see the heart of God. I've got a plan. Mm-hmm. And what's so neat, Terry, is to realize that before God ever created the world, he knew man would sin.
Yeah.
In his omniscience, and before the creation of the world, they had a plan of redemption. Jesus Christ was the Lamb of God slain before the foundation of the world.
Yeah.
You know, we have people, we work in 184 countries and 70 languages, 70 plus, and we're teaching people how to discover truth for themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I know that I know that I know absolute truth,
yeah,
and if I know that I got it from God, because that's what the Bible is, it's the Word of God, then I can walk with confidence and not fear. When Jesus was here in Luke chapter 12, he knows that they're coming after him, and he knows what's going to happen. And so he turns to the 12, and he's preparing them, and he's telling them that you're going to go through trials, you're going to be hauled to courts and everything. And then he says to them, he says, do not be afraid of those who kill the body.
Yes.
And have no more that they can do. But I will warn you whom to fear. Fear the one who after he has, and this is very important, after he has killed, he has authority to cast into hell. Yes, I say fear him. He's saying fear my Father.
Yes.
And but the thing that's so neat, if you read it carefully, and that's what we teach people to do, to study the Bible inductively using the precept method. But what you discover is that Jesus is the one that determines the time of death. I cannot keep myself alive any longer than he has foreordained in Psalm 139. He numbered our days when as yet there was not one of them. If I'm fearing God and I'm trusting God, these people in these Muslim countries that are constantly facing death, imprisonment, torture, and that, we have a 40-minute, heaven, hell, and life after death. We have one on free from the bondage of fear.
Wow.
And those people, it's been translated into Farsi and into Arabic and into all these other languages. And those people are studying what God says. Mm-hmm. It's not a book where I write about a subject. The subject is the book. And you study it and discover it for yourself.
Yeah.
And they're saying they're free.
Yeah.
They're free because they understand God's sovereign. He wounds, he heals, he kills, he makes alive. He's the Lord that does all these things. He has a time. No one can touch me without his permission, you know. And so I don't have to fear.
Anything.
Not anything. And today, in this era of political correctness in the United States of America, if we're fearing for our job, I mean, we ought to be fearing God. And saying, God, I'm your man. I'm your woman. This is what your book says. I am not going to compromise. I'm not going to be politically correct. I'm not going to turn to the right. I'm not going to turn to the left. You say, when you talk about those that are in hell, the first one are the cowardly. And that's what he says. I'm not going to be a coward. I'm going to hold forth your word. I'm going to trust you. You're the one that promises to supply all my needs. You know, you will move on the body of Christ or whatever to take care of me. I'm your man. I'm your woman.
You know, the political correctness that exists in our world today, combined with the biblical ignorance, has put us in a very perilous position. For someone like you who has been teaching people for years how to take line upon line, precept upon precept, what is the antidote to the scenario that we find ourselves in as Americans? I find that people in other countries like you're talking about, especially in places of turmoil like the Middle East, Somalia, places like that, they already have a perspective of eternity, and they don't have that same kind of fear. Is it because we haven't been taught well? Is it because we're enjoying our blessings so much we can't get there from here? What is it?
I think it's because we've entangled ourselves with the affair of this life.
Yeah.
And so we don't have time for God. We've marginalized Him. We'll read Christian novels. We'll read Christian books, but we won't read the book.
Yeah.
This is the only place where absolute truth is. And we say we can't understand it. And my passion, this is why I'm 81 and I have not retired and I will not retire, you know, until God retires me, but is to establish people in God's word so that they can say, I have not turned aside from your ordinances, for you yourself have taught me. And I know that I know in Daniel 11, and it's like our times, but there was compromise. And it talks about those that did not compromise. And it said, but the people who know their God will be able to stand firm, but not just to stand firm like this.
Fearfully,
but to take action.
Bold.
Bold. And that's what we need today. And I personally believe that the reason the United States of America is in the mess that it's in is because the church, and I'm talking about the body of Christ, has ignored the word of God. We've gone to entertainment. We've gone to, you know, trying to make the gospel palatable. And everybody's trying to make everything palatable to people so that we don't have any convictions. It's got to stop. And so my passion, the passion of David Arthur, who's the CEO now, of our whole staff and around the world, is to have people discover truth for themselves.
Back to the book.
That's
back
the book.
To the book.
And then to live, as Jesus said, man does not live by bread alone, but by
every word.
And I love this, and it's in one of the Gospels, that comes from the mouth of God. This is what's come from the mouth of God.
Yeah.
And I'm to fear God. To fear God means I'm to respect Him, I'm to trust Him, I'm to honor Him for who He is. Mm-hmm. And when I do, then the fear of man fades.
Exactly. Boy, what a word for today. Thank you so much for that encouragement. I want you to know, Kay Arthur's 6-week no homework, boy, that's a word for the day we live in, Bible study is called Heaven, Hell, and Life After Death. It's one of many. She's been teaching the word for years. All her studies are available nationwide, and we thank you for bringing this word to us.
Yes, and they're on precept.org, and they can find them and use them.
There you go. That's what we need to do.
That's what we need to do.